these trappers trying to claim rep. Fuck the culture, let the vultures pull their wigs back. We dig that, you see I'm all about the composition. Overwritten, if it's trash, suffocate you with scotch tape in a trash bag. I supply the streets with heavy rap, then let the metal clap. Round of applause until his lungs collapse. I hit them lunges on an iron track. I mean, you tried to act. The curtains closed and they don't want you back. They put a price on his fucking head. I left the city red. My soul is cursed like the evil dead.
I Trapped the Devil. I Trapped the Devil is an independent film that was written by Josh Lobo. Stars AJ Bowen, Jocelyn Donahue, and Scott Poitras. Now, the film centers around a man who's in a car with his wife on his way to go see his brother in the house. They park outside and talk about how it's been a while. And, you know, there's some sort of traumatic event that happened with the family. And as the brother and wife enter the home, the older brother just seems completely on edge. He seems off. Seems like there's something wrong with him. He doesn't seem normal. His interactions just seem like out of place, and like he's not really in the moment with his brother and wife. They kind of have a strained relationship. You can tell, you know, he's kind of the brother whose house they visit. He doesn't really say much. He's pretty quiet to the other brother, and there's some family drama. Eventually, the older brother takes his younger brother upstairs, asks him about evil. What does he think about it? And as the title implied, I Trapped the Devil, he believes that he has trapped the devil inside of his basement. Now, there are a lot of independent films that are art house horror movies, but they're more art house than horror. There's really a bunch of films that are just ambiguous for no reason. They're pretentious. They really have no meaning at all. Or if they did have a meaning, the director just completely lost whatever meaning that he tried to give in the video based on how he decided to tell the story he wanted to tell, to convey the message he wanted to convey. And that is not the case with this film, I Trapped the Devil. Now, this film, if you're a fan of the slow burn horror movies, if you're a fan of slow paced horror movies that really build tension, like really, really eerie horror movies that give you a sense of just dread, unrelenting dread, just completely soul-crushing dread to the point where you almost feel concerned for your mental health while watching movies. Now, this may just be for me, but movies that affected me to the capacity that this one did, that I Trapped the Devil did, would have to be Mother, Hereditary, Black Swan, kind of. These type of films, and oh, The Witch, definitely The Witch. These type of films are really, really intense. The movie I Trapped the Devil is so atmospheric. The atmosphere is so beautiful, and that's what I love with horror movies now, because I'm, you know, a lot of us have grown tired of this popcorn fucking The Nun movie and La Llorona. Those movies are literally the same thing. Jump scare, camera pans away, camera comes back, jump scare. It's old. It's really old. And I can see why a lot of people who used to like horror movies are turned off to horror movies, because of how ridiculous the majority of the ones that Hollywood puts out are. Now, this film here is definitely in my top 10 horror movies of 2019. Off top, definitely in my top 10, right? So as a story, this is a spoiler free review. So the movie pretty much the cinematography is beautiful. They really play on the isolation, because it's not a very big cast for this movie. There's literally maybe 5 characters this entire film. You have 2 cops. Then you have the brother that's visiting along with his wife. And it really plays into that paranoia, because as he has this, whatever he has trapped in there, something's there, obviously. But the way that the thing is basically trying to plead to them to let him out of the cage. Not the one who locked him in a basement, but the brother and the wife that go in a basement. And essentially, he tells them that it appears basically what you see is what it embodies, like what you want to see, what your weakness is, something that affects you and makes you emotional. That's what it would use to try to get out of this basement. The entire movie essentially is just the brother slowly kind of losing his mind as he's down there with this devil trapped in a basement, and the wife is being enticed to go open it. And it's just paranoia on top of paranoia on top of just tension, to the point there's one scene where absolutely nothing happens. It just slowly zooms in to this red door that this brother believes he trapped the devil in. And the tension was so goddamn strong when I was watching it. It felt so beautiful. I have anxiety. So certain movies, like I said, Hereditary, Mother, movies like that affect me really, really bad because I have anxiety. And for some reason, that tends to be the only type of horror films right now that I love, which you would think is kind of idiotic. Why would you watch stuff that gives you anxiety if you already have anxiety? For some reason, I don't know. It feels like I could just focus in my anxieties on all the outer shit and just focus on one single point, which is these type of films. And I Trapped the Devil is rated as a 4.8 out of 10 on IMDb, which is ridiculous because I don't understand how. I mean, I get it. This movie's not really that much of an art house film for the most part. There's just a simple scene at the ending. They decided to go a pretty ambiguous route, but not really that ambiguous to where you can't understand or figure out what happened. You understand what I'm saying? This is a very well made, very well put together film. I'm telling you, trauma from the past, the out of control spiral from the paranoia, the eerie music, the dread, the tension that creeps up behind you, the anticipation of a jump scare that never happens, but it's just as satisfying because it built that tension and dread and didn't give you a release. It just kept building on top of that dread and building and building and building on top of that dread until the movie's climax. Now, to be fair, I will say that if you're not a fan of ambiguous horror films, if you're not a fan of the slow burn horror films that are more artsy and takes its time with its characters and to develop the world in which this movie is created in, this probably won't be a film for you. If you didn't like A Cure for Wellness, not comparing like as far as A Cure for Wellness was a mainstream horror film that was like a modern day Hammer horror film, but it was extremely slow. For a lot of people, if they weren't interested in the story enough, in the atmosphere and the cinematography, if that wasn't enough to keep you in the dialogue. So if you're not pretty much, you're just looking to be entertained and not really wanting to be captivating by the way someone films something or the way somebody conveys a certain message or the tone and the atmosphere and a route that they chose to go with the dialogue and with the being ambiguous. If you didn't enjoy A Cure for Wellness, if you didn't enjoy Hereditary, if you didn't enjoy Mother, you probably won't enjoy this movie. But horror is subjective. We all have our personal taste. You know what I'm saying? I asked what kind of movies induce like dread and tension. I've been searching on the internet. People say stuff like Slither and like fucking Crawl. You know, that was a good animal creature feature monster movie. I mean, Crawl was good, but it does nothing. The only type of films that ever affected me in my adulthood to the capacity of where I was actually worried, like I said, is I Trapped the Devil, Mother, and Hereditary, and The Witch. Yeah, so if you're on a high, if you're on one of those binges like I am, just looking for the most disturbing type of horror films with atmosphere that cause unrelenting dread and tension, definitely I Trapped the Devil is the movie for you, because this movie is amazing. I can't harp on enough how well put together this film is made. Like I said, very small cast. They probably didn't have a big budget, and yet this film is creepier and more fear-inducing and dread-inducing than any film in a Conjuring universe, and there is nothing supernatural that you see through this entire film until about the climax. And that's how effective this movie is. It found a way, while being a low budget horror film, to be so effective, barely showing anything paranormal aside from a voice behind a fucking creepy red door that the camera always slowly pans in on with crosses on it. And it talks about things, you know, if evil is evil, really, is evil just an energy outside of man that influences people? Or is evil really a being that you can trap? Is evil just within us? And it touches on some heavy themes. It deals with grief and loss, regret of losing a child. This movie's really good. This movie's very good. Like I said, I'll give this movie a 9 out of 10. You know what I'm saying? This like I said, I can't harp on it enough. This fucking film is amazing. If you haven't seen I Trapped the Devil, directed by Josh Lobo, I suggest you go watch it because this fucking movie is worth it. Now, the payoff at the end was satisfying. A lot of times with these types of horror films, the payoffs are very bad. And one film in particular is fucking horrible. This is the worst, slowest paced fucking horror movie that just didn't do anything to me at all. And that is fucking The Wind. Oh my God. Talk about fucking boring and slow paced with no fucking payoff at all. But that's for another video. I'm gonna get into that and just fucking completely destroy that. I'm also on this channel. So right now, the shows that I'm gonna be providing are just overall horror movie reviews will be one aspect of the channel. Also, another aspect of the channel is gonna be devoted to very bad horror films or horror films that I've personally hated, regardless of the popularity or how well they did. And the last review is gonna be, just unsettling slow burn horror films, the dread, basically. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, we all dread lords and dread emperors over here. So if you like this page, you appreciate it. If you like the content, if you want to see more content, follow me at Patreon. I can be found in the link below. Get at me on Patreon so we can start building this channel for all these other horror lovers. Peace.